Calvin Ciano, Wofford College, outside linebacker, number 4. It's a great honor. I know there are plenty of great football players out there, and to be mentioned and put on the same list as those is a great honor. I'm definitely looking forward to living up to the honor in itself. It's wonderful. I mean, you look at Von Miller, Patrick Peterson. I mean, they had great college careers on to NFL, and hopefully, I can follow in their footsteps and make that move to the next level and be successful. I pride myself on being well-rounded, if you would say. I like to rush the pass, to working on different pass rush moves, being quick with my hands and whatnot. Getting a great takeoff, running, going down in the backfield, whatever the case may be. Stuffing holes, being a run stopper, and getting off the blocks. Being a defender, pass defender, dropping technique, taking proper angles, and keying on different things the quarterback might give away or the receiver might give away on different routes and schemes they're trying to do. So, I guess my well-roundedness would be the thing I would pride myself on. Yes, Wofford has a very good reputation in academics. I'm currently majoring in physics and minoring in mathematics. It's going well for me. About 85-90% completion on my major. It's looking well for me, and I plan on graduating with a 3.0 is my goal. So I'm looking forward to getting a degree from a school with a stature like Wofford College, and the football don't work out, I have a great degree to lean back on. Quantum physics in the physics realm, that would be one of the harder classes I've taken so far. Just talks about how different particles move and that different atoms, and it's real detail. It's not like in elementary you learn proton, neutron, electron, and that's it pretty much for the atom. But as you develop and go deeper and deeper, it's so much more than those three parts of an atom and what the things that we see on an everyday basis, how matter makes up everything around us. It's definitely very interesting, and I take great joy in learning about it and understanding it. Well, I definitely would think that would have give me an edge up on people being down on things, have that physics background, knowing that I'm smaller than the old lineman, so I'm going to use my skills to my advantage, and their momentum cannot be quickly shifted as mine can, so, different aspects like that, I definitely try to use to my advantage and with pass rushing. Yeah, I grew up in Palace, Louisiana. It was like 10, 15 minutes from New Orleans. My dad, he went to Southern University, had an electrical engineering degree, and he's working at a Marathon Oil Petroleum. And my mom, she went to a trade school and she ended up becoming a secretary. She worked at the high school, and they're two of my greatest role models in my life. I mean, they definitely hold me to a high standard. In the classroom, on the field, and in life in general. I can remember as a child, the A's were good, B's were, that's okay. D's, F's, none of that was really acceptable. And, normally kids might be happy with just passing, but it's passing. Passing is just is not cutting it in my household. And, coming from a family with six brothers and sisters, there's a lot of greatly appreciate from my parents passing down on to me and having me a disciplined person in general, and everything that I take part in, I do it to the best of my ability, and never quit and finish it. So I definitely appreciate them for that. Every once in a while, I do snack a little bit. I play video games and all that, like any other college student or athlete would do. But as far as having a biggest one, I wouldn't say that there's anything in particular that I could think about. I definitely try to lead by example and hold my teammates accountable when it comes to different things like that. So, I can't hold someone else accountable when I'm not, I can't talk when I'm not walking the walk myself. So, I try not to go extreme and beyond on things of that nature. Something funny that happened to me since I've been at Wofford College. Usually, my mom and dad, they can attest to this story. Every time I go home to my family or different relatives' house, they always want me to tell this story because I guess they think it's so funny. But my freshman year, my parents bought me a bike, a little mountain bike from Walmart. Not too special, but something that'll do, I guess. They thought. South Carolina is fairly hilly. It's not flat like Louisiana is. So I remember the day before training camp, we moving into our training camp dorms, the freshman dorms that we're gonna live in for camp. And I had a big duffel bag. It had to weigh about roughly 40 pounds at least. And I had it on my back riding the bike down the hill. The hill is pretty steep. I'm going down there. I'm guessing I'm going like 30, 40 miles an hour as well. So, got a big bag on your back, going super fast, not really a good mixture. And I made a turn into the parking lot. I'm going down the parking lot that's right in front of the door where I'm going to unload all my stuff fast so I can move it in my room. To give you an idea how fast I was moving, like another one of the football players, he was like right outside his car in the parking lot. And like I seen him on my side, so I hollered at him, just like, yo, what's up? By the time he turned around to see who it was, I had already done flew by him, so he had to turn back to where he was facing to, see who it was, and that's to give you an idea how fast I was going. But right in front, the patio area, like right where the doors were, there were like three flights of stairs. And so there's three flights of stairs. So stairs, big bag, and you're going at like 40 miles an hour on the bike. Still, add things up, still not a good predicament to be in. I hit the brakes to bar from beating over the stairs, trying to do whatever. I hit the brakes. Like I told you earlier, it's a Walmart bike. No knock on Walmart at all, but it's not the best of bikes out there to be riding. I hit the brakes, and the brakes don't really slow me down. I'm only slowing probably like half a mile an hour. So now I'm faced with a decision. I can either jump these flight of stairs or just jump off the bike altogether, period. And me being the challenger that I am, always liking to prove myself, I chose to jump the stairs. And, all right, I'm on the bike, going, heading to the first flight. Right before I get to the first flight, I jump up. I actually jump the first 5 steps. Just, I mean, it's like probably, you know, 3 or 4 steps. Here, nothing too big, but a decent amount. I jumped the first flight. I landed. And then, you know, this time, I jumped the first flight. I'm thinking I'm good. I'm thinking, like, I could do this. This shouldn't be too bad. I jumped all the flights until I got to the last flight of stairs. And I guess I was going too fast. I end up jumping up. But when I came down, the front wheel just went all kind of directions, went straight. And I end up, the front rim end up breaking, the back I had on my back, big heavy back, end up flipping over my head. I end up falling off the bike, the handlebars, the rims was bent up, and it just was not a pretty good outcome. The friend I end up passed by in the parking lot, he ran over. All you hear was a big loud bang. He ran over and busted our last. And that definitely, I've never had a bike since freshman year. I can tell you that much. Elvin Sienna, Wofford College, number 4 outside linebacker. I would like to thank all of the Wofford Terrier fans for tuning in to this interview. We plan on making this a great season, and we definitely will not fall short. The championship is the goal, and no one will stop us from reaching it. Thank you.